Good morning. Welcome to the Miley Cyrus video. I've been wanting to make this for a while, but I needed time to process the album, to digest the album, to get a little bit of a long-lasting effect, to really know what I was going to talk about in this video. So now we're here, and there's a couple things I want to talk about. So Miley Cyrus has done a lot of stuff since the last video I made about her. So I think I'm just going to go in chronological order and talk about all the stuff she's done in the last, 2 years, I think it's been. Obviously, Miley Cyrus just released her album. But before that, I think in 2018, she had a plan to release 3 separate smaller EPs. And then those 3 EPs would combine to be 1 large album. The first EP was called She Is Coming. And then I think the album title was going to be She Is Miley Cyrus or something like that. I'm not really sure because she scrapped all that. Well, she did say a lot of the work burned down in a fire. Her house caught on fire. And so her house burned down and she lost all that work. And then she got divorced. So she was none of this is relevant anymore really to me. So just going to scrap that project, which I respect. I'd rather her scrap something and start anew and do something good than try to force out something that is not good or not relevant anymore to her. The first EP, She Is Coming, I think I liked 3 songs off there. I think I like Mother's Daughter, Drugs Rule Everything Around Me, and then Party Up the Street. Is that what it's called? See, I can't remember what it's called. I don't really listen to those anymore except for Mother's Daughter. Speaking of Mother's Daughter, the Mother's Daughter music video, excellent. Excellent stuff. I'll watch that twice a week. So then she was like, okay, I'm scrapping that. Cool. Then she went around doing all these covers, okay? She did a Black Dog cover. She did a Zombies cover, Cranberries cover. She did, obviously, a Blondie cover, Heart of Glass. All 3 of those slap. I listen to them literally all the time. But I really liked the Cranberries cover. She looked so iconic, and her voice, she's doing this gravelly thing now. There's just something in her voice where she's been doing it in all the covers, and she does it in some of the songs on the new album too. And it's just perfect. It's perfect for rock. And that's what everybody was saying on TikTok when Heart of Glass blew up on there. Her voice is just perfect for rock. So then she releases Midnight Sky, which if I call it Midnight Sun in this video, just let it slide, okay? I'm sorry. Midnight Sky and the video, both iconic. She directed that video too. Talent, vision, okay? I love that song. I'd rate that song maybe an 8 out of 10 because when Stevie Nicks got on it, 10 out of 10. The Midnight Sky remix with Stevie Nicks is a 10 out of 10 song. Perfect song. So then the singles off the album, she technically put the covers that she did. She put Zombie and Heart of Glass on the album technically. And then the singles were Midnight Sky. And then she released Prisoner as a single. And that music video changed me, I think. Someone said Dua Lipa can match Miley's energy. And I agree 1000%. But also, them two together. Wow. And I'll talk about this more when I talk about the album. But the album is, it sounds like 80s rock. 80s-influenced rock, but still, modern enough. You know? It's not, completely copying 80s rock music. And that's, what Dua did on Future Nostalgia, but for, disco. You know, so I feel her voice fit in really well with this album and specifically this song. So I really like Prisoner also. Okay, let's talk about the album. So the album is called Plastic Hearts. I hate that name. I don't like the name at all. It's serving very 2010, serving very 2013 vibes. I don't like the name at all. I'm sorry. It's cheesy. It's serving very Marina and the Diamonds. You know what I'm saying? And the album isn't cheesy. I'd rather the album be called Golden G-String, if I'm being honest. I think that would have been the perfect album title. Okay, so I'm not going to rank the songs on the album, but I'm going to do, I think I have a top three, and then I have songs I like, and then I have songs I don't really like. My favorite song on the album is Hate Me, and then my second favorite song on the album is Angels Like You. My third favorite song on the album is Gimme What I Want. Okay, and this is excluding the covers, by the way. Love all the covers, but I'm not including them in the album. And then the other songs that I like are Golden G-String, Prisoner, Midnight Sky, and Night Crawling. Okay, so that means the rest of them I don't really love. And I'm not saying that I won't like them later. Maybe I will revisit this album sometime in the future and I will connect with those songs more, but I feel like they're not very memorable. Like, they didn't like stick in my head. Like, the first time I heard Gimme What I Want, immediately stuck in my head. So then the ones that I don't really like are What the Fuck Do I Know, Plastic Hearts, Hi, Bad Karma, and Never Be Me. And Never Be Me is not bad. None of these songs are like bad. I don't like actively hate any of them except for What the Fuck Do I Know and Plastic Hearts. I don't like those at all. I feel like they're very cheesy songs. The rest I'm kind of neutral on, but I don't love them. So overall, I like the 80s rock like aesthetic. I like that it sounds different from anything else released. I like that she doesn't feel like she needs to go super poppy. The reason I love Miley Cyrus, and I'll stan Miley Cyrus until I'm dead, is, like, look at her discography. So, bangers, ignoring the Hannah Montana stuff, which is also straight bops. Bangers is, like, rap, like, hip-hop inspired. Then we have Dead Pets, which is, like, psychedelic, alternative rock pop. Then Younger Now is, like, 50s inspired, kind of country, a little bit country pop with like influences from the 50s. She Is Coming, the six songs we got from that are back to like pop. Now we have Plastic Hearts, which is like 80s rock inspired. I'm gonna say something. I really like this album and I like the 80s rock thing for her, but when I heard the Cranberries cover, I wanted more like that. Like, I wanted more actual rock. And I feel like the 80s pop rock thing, it just wasn't what I was like expecting when she said a rock album, especially when she's covering Cranberries, she's covering Led Zeppelin. And I guess Blondie should have been a tell, but I kind of expected it to be like more like those things, which is why I like the covers. Don't come for me, but I'm kind of getting a little bit of Bret Michaels, a little bit of Every Rose Has Its Thorns from a couple songs on here, from Hate Me and Angels Like You, which I like. And they're very sing songs that I can sing out loud in my car, which is what I want from an album, especially what I want from Miley Cyrus' album. So overall, I'd say this is I'm gonna give it a 7 out of 10. And I'm being generous with a 7 because I like the aesthetic and I like the majority of the songs on the album. I still will defend Dead Pets until the day I die. I think that my album ranking overall for her would be number one is Bangers, number two is Dead Pets, this album would be number three, and then I would do She Is Coming, and then I would do Younger Now. And I'm counting She Is Coming because it was an EP, so it's gonna be counted. But I would put this is like not anywhere near the level of Bangers or Dead Pets. And even Dead Pets, there's like songs I don't listen to on the album, but the other songs I do listen to are so like lyrically good and different sounding, it like puts it above this record. I'm just gonna be honest, tracks 1 and 2, What the Fuck Do I Know and Plastic Hearts, like, bring this album's rating down so much. I don't know why Plastic Hearts was the title track for this album. It's not good. I don't like that song. And I don't like What the Fuck Do I Know. Now, don't clock me. I am a Miley Cyrus stan. I'm a Miley stan. I listen to this album all the time. I probably listen to Hate Me like once a day. And that's like one of my favorite songs from her. Ever. Everything that Miley does visually is perfect. The aesthetic of this album, she just knew what she was doing. Like, in her eras, she has a very consistent like look, She has a very consistent sound. The songs that she's covering, like throughout every era of her album, she's been doing backyard sessions, you know, and the songs that she covers there, like, give hints towards what the album's going to be. Like, she does a good job creating eras, which is, like, what you do when you are, like, a legend. Like, Miley Cyrus is a pop legend, one of the best pop artists that will ever be. I don't care. I said it. So I like this whole era. I like this whole thing. There are, like, 4 songs on the album where I just wish that they weren't there. That's really all I have to say about this album. A 7 out of 10. I'm not gushing over it. I'm happy that it was the number one rock album. I want her to succeed. I wish it was more rock. Yeah, there's nothing else to say. Stream Plastic Hearts. Stream her covers. Go watch the music video for Midnight Sky. Yeah, see you on the next one.